people who aren't familiar with the art form, can you define kirtan? What is it?
Yes, well, the term is from India, and although we say in the West, we say kirtan, in India, the pronunciation would be kirtan. And it is a music that has been developed perhaps more in the villages and more in the homes than anywhere else. The purpose of it is for devotion to what some may call God or the divine essence within all beings. And kirtan is practiced in many walks of life in the ancient Indian cultures. And the kind of kirtan that I grew up with is from the Sikh tradition, which people in Canada are probably very familiar with the progressive kind of environment there. And in the Sikh traditional kind of kirtan, we chant and sing these words from our masters, from our gurus, who lived between the 15th century and 17th century in northern India. And also incorporated within the Sikh teachings are poems, ecstatic poems, and writings from masters of other traditions as well, Sufi, Hindu, Muslim, along with the Sikh gurus. And the poems themselves are really, in essence, ecstatic poems of union with this divine essence or spirit within all beings or divinity. And the way that it's practiced is that you can obtain the consciousness of union, that merger or enlightenment of the original reciter of those sacred poems by reciting those poems yourself. And kirtan is traditionally done in call and response form so that the kirtan leader wouldn't be considered a performer, but would be considered someone who's helping the congregation or the community to chant, to imbibe these words and experience these words of ecstasy and bliss. Incorporating many of the Sikh chants. So I grew up with this tradition, and in my kind of high school days, I got very involved in social activism. We started recycling at our high school and Rainforest Awareness Week, and a lot of what we did in our activism was we incorporated music, and I was a guitar player and sang. And I saw how songs could change consciousness, and I began to incorporate the Sikh chants into some of this intention, and saw how it wasn't just transforming consciousness, but healing as well, and bringing healing to people. And so as things would develop in my late 20s, early 30s, I became very passionate about bringing these chants out to the greater public to bring healing through music.
You used a really interesting word a minute ago, imbibe these words, as though you're taking in the essence of something. I want to ask you about the syllables you're chanting. When they come from sacred text, when they come from poetry, what makes these syllables different than other sounds? Where does the power reside in the syllables you chant?
In essence, these chants are positive affirmations you could say, if you really just wanted to give a quick definition, that's what I would say to somebody. They're positive affirmations of the divine within, of courage within, truth within, and therefore also being able to connect with the divine and the truth and courage in our environments as well. And there are lots of wonderful studies happening at many universities now. It's becoming more commonplace knowledge that you can reduce stress, all sorts of things, through chanting these sacred chants. And, you know, I feel honored, I feel excited to be a part of this movement of bringing this these kinds of chants and this kind of music out into the world.